This ayah from Surah Luqman, which is already started second episode yesterday in the chapter of Luqman. Al-Hakim, the wise Luqman, they call him. Luqman, he was from Abyssinia, actually, from Sudan. He was a Sudanese guy, very tall, skinny, long nose, and the big ears, and the small head. And he was a black guy, subhanAllah. And he was very skinny, and he was a slave for his master too. And he has chapter in the Quran by his name, because he was very wise, and because of his wisdom and his iman too. Anyway, this ayah and chapter of Luqman, the wise, verse number 6, talks about something we are really, all of the world, and they are, it's kind of fitna now. What the ayah is saying? The verse is saying here, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزُوًا وفي قراءة هُزُوًا أُولَئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. This ayah, Allah subhanahu is telling us, and of the people is who, or is he who buys idle talk to mislead others from the way of Allah Azza wa Jal without knowledge, and who takes the way of Allah or takes it, the Sirat al-Mustaqim or Islam in ridicule. Those will have a humiliating punishment. What is the meaning of this ayah starting to tell us? The message of this ayah. This verse refers to those who engage in destruction or activities that lead people away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. During doing what they used to do, or say these people, they are doing, يعني subhanAllah, just vain talks, and they try to take Islam, which is serious. They mock Muslims. These people, they are mocking Muslims and they making fun of Muslims. I take Islam is just like that lightly. These people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them in the day of judgment. And they said, "Women, men here like tabgid, يعني not all of the people, some of the people. What they are doing? These people, subhanAllah, they take lahu al-hadith instead of making zikr Allah or following the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. They make it fun. And these people, they are misguiding others of what they are doing, but without knowledge, like what they said. And he's considering the sabilillah or the way of Allah or ayatillah or deen Allah, the religion of Allah." Like sukhriya, mocking, just making fun of this, subhanAllah. Istihza, these people, they will be humiliated. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about these people. Some scholar, like not scholar, sahaba, like Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, they said, lahu al-hadith here means al-ghina, singing. But if you go more, lahu al-hadith, anything lahu means, because we have different meaning in or definition in Arabic between, Allah mentioned these two words, lahu and la'ib. La'ib means the play. And Allah mentioned in too many ayat, I'lamu, for example, I'lamu annama al-hayat al-dunya, lahun wa la'ib. Lahun wa la'ib. طيب, lahu lahu eh? The amusement. What about the la'ib? Playing. And the playing for the kids, little kids, like the khali yal'ab, the ayil. If somebody's playing, it's like he's not mature. No تكليف, little kid, let him play. That's called لعب in Arabic, or the Quran mentioned لعب. What about اللهو? اللهو means that little kid became mature, and he became adult like us, and he is in amusement. اللعب, اللهو, what's اللهو? اللهو, something has no value, and subhanAllah, you're blessed with something has value. يعني, for example, you're sitting just watching movie or something, or wasting your time for nothing, and you're subhanAllah, you're ignoring your salawat. Your ibadah, this call lahu. Why you're doing that? You're mukallaf. Allah will ask you about this. But anyway, let's see what Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Sahabi, and Abdullah ibn Abbas, the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they give a definition of this word in this ayah specifically. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ. What's لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ? لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ, they said, the songs, الغناء. This is their explanation. Is الغناء singing or the songs is halal or haram? Some scholars they said halal, it's okay. Some scholars they said haram. Let's see what both are saying. طيب, what kind of غناء is halal? What kind of some scholars said it's halal. It's how is halal? They said الغناء it's كلام. It's كلام يعني poems. Poems, it's كلام, شعر. Okay. حلال it's حلال حرام it's حرام like what like the knife in the kitchen you can kill somebody with it and you can use it in the kitchen right the TV or the your cellular phone you can watch bad stuff and you can listen to the Quran also and get they said this is what they said حلال it's حلال حرام it's حرام it depends طيب let's see let's compare it with what happened during the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم One time, Abu Bakr, in the day of Bu'ath, it was a Eid day, festival for Arab. He saw like two little girls, they are singing in the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, carrying duff. Duff is something like this. No instruments, nothing. And they start singing. And Abu Bakr was so mad. He said, a muzmar shaitan in the house of Rasulullah. Ghina, it's called muzmar shaitan. The flute of shaitan. This in the house of Rasulullah, Rasul said, Abu Bakr, leave them. إِنَّهُ يَوْمَ عِيدٍ This is the day of Eid. Let them become happy. طيب, let's explain the hadith. First of all, they were jariyatayn. What is a jariya in Islam? Little girl. Maybe 7 years, not 2, 9 years. Jariya. Let's tell little girl. طيب, what kind of singing? They had duff like this. Something has, not tabla, even tabla is haram. This duff has something, has no instruments. And they were singing like, talking highly about the tribes, about the war, about something like that. It is not like our songs now, talking about women and the body of women, okay? Or the video clip and naked women dancing and among men, okay? Don't tell me to compare this with that. It's completely different. طيب, what about Anjasha? Anjasha, he was a slave. And one of the wives of Rasulullah ﷺ was riding the camel and inside the houses, the box, they put it above the camel, you know, to cover her. And the camel, you know, is so high, you have to be professional to ride it. And the Anjasha, while he was carrying the rope and the, guiding the camel to the way, he starts singing, كَنَا يَحْدُو Singing, ارتجاز or singing, no instruments. No, الفرقة الموسيقية and with all of the behind him, he was just a man walking, just like somebody talking to himself. I was singing, and Anjasha, he had very sweet voice. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ruwaidan, ya Anjasha, rifkan bil qawarir, rifkan bil qawarir." And النهاردة بنقول رفقاً بالبراليس. بال قوارير قوارير دور إيش أخوين؟ القوارير دول the wives of Rasulullah. They were so lovely, kind women, they very polite, they knew how to deal with their husbands. That's why Rasulullah sallam, he said, the similarity of my wife, like qarura, qarura, piece of glass. Yeah, piece of glass. He said, rifqan, take it easy. Maybe the camel will think about what you're saying, and the camel will fall down, and the lady above the camel, she's gonna be broken, you're gonna kill her. You know, like if you have a piece of glass and you're gonna fall down from your hand, you're gonna break it. For he said, rifqan, take it easy, anjasha. He was saying what? Just normal words. طب what about Rasulullah himself? كان يرتجز. But Rasulullah never said the شعر. الصحابة they used to repeat and he was repeating with them. What did he say? When he was, they were digging the ditch around the Medina. What happened? الصحابة they used to make حداء or ارتجاز. They used to say poems or شعر just to urge everybody to work. سبحان الله. And the Rasul was repeating with him what they used to say. This is the songs of the Sahab. What they used to say. أتيناكم أتيناكم المهاجرين الأنصار. They are working, digging the ditch. أتيناكم أتيناكم المهاجرين they used to sing for الأنصار. The Rasul was repeating with him. What? أتيناكم أتيناكم فحيونا نحييكم ولولا الحنطة السوداء ما سمنت عذاريكم. This is a شعر. This is the songs. They يقول لك حلال now. We come to you. As مهاجرين telling الأنصار while they were digging the ditch around the Medina. What? فحيونا نحييكم you will come us and we are welcoming you. ولولا الحنطة السوداء and because of the black seed, your little girls will never be gonna be strong and big bodies, mashallah, and beautiful. ما سمنت عذاريكم يعني they will grow up. This is the meaning. See? Nowadays, look at the songs. A man is talking about the body of the woman. And all, أستغفر الله العظيم, حرام. Women naked dancing, video clips, spending lots of money for it, misguiding people. For that's why I'm telling you from that, especially with the instruments, because we have too many hadiths saying the instruments haram. The tabla haram, the hadith said al-ud, it's haram, the flute is haram. All of this, I have too many hadiths. فanyway the instruments plus what the kind of songs imagine impolite ones misguiding people misleading people سبحان الله wasting the time of people سبحان instead of Quran or the Deen of Allah or the remembrance of Allah they are using these things and from this I can say haram the songs are haram nowadays all haram 100% yes but of all kind of songs I'm just trying to compare what Rasulullah used to do with Sahaba and Hadith Abu Bakr and Anjasha of course it's haram but if for example let's say somebody saying this kind of poems like the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to urge the workers to work say for example salli ala nabi or something like that or that lady she's trying to let her baby sleep she's saying some songs it's innocent ones يعني there is nothing wrong with that you know but somebody's talking about القدس or Palestine or المسجد الأقصى or there is nothing wrong with that but if what we see that the video clips and all of this haram stuff you see it in TikTok and this is all haram this is haram 100% for that's why you have to know Allah a'lam this is my opinion regarding that and lahu al-hadith anything cannot mislead people or take them away from the remembrance of Allah zikr Allah al-Quran and the deen subhanallah otherwise it will be all haram and for me now سبحان الله الغناء الماجن الذي يدعو إلى المعاصي calling people to disobey Allah or disturbing people from the ذكر الله and the الصلاة العبادة all of this حرام and مذموم it's حرام so I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى يا رب to guide us to سواء السبيل and my, يعني المنهج المسلم أو الشيخ أبو بكر الجزائري he mentioned 11 names or more for the الغناء the songs And it is in the Quran. سبحانه السامدون لهو الباطل مزمور الشيطان لهو الحديث. There are too many names for this. So we have to be careful from that. Instead of somebody's listening to a song or something, listen to the Quran. Make zikr, استغفار, لا حول ولا إله إلا الله. Our time is very short. Instead of that, don't, يعني سبحان الله, taking sin. Instead of make حسنات. It's instead of that. I'm asking Allah عز وجل أن يتقبل منا وإياكم ربنا.